That's why it's happening. So when I was making these presentations, the first thing came into my mind, a new user. Because a new user scratching his head, what probe should I use? Like you can see, I have made a picture which have different probe names and a person with a question mark. That's a big question it comes to our mind when we start using texture analyzer. So I would like to ask a question actually before commencing further. Do you know about the nomenclature? How we name the probes? It is written P by 2, P by 6 and all. We don't know about it. Fine. So the accessories and attachments, these are classified as independent probes which have a prefix of P. You must have seen P by 2, P by 6, P by 75, P by 100. And we have attachments which has an independent prefix A. These are called accessories. Right, so whichever have this P will require a heavy duty platform for testing. You all may be knowing heavy duty platform, fine, because you are all users. And which have the A as a prefix, that is an independent accessory and it doesn't need HDP, heavy duty platform. You have to remove it and you have to fix it on the instrument base directly. Fine. So now the selection criteria. So whenever selecting a probe, we need to keep few things in mind. First, would be the sample type. We have discussed it quite a lot in the previous session. The sample type is the most important thing. We will discuss it further extensively. Then the type of test. What type of test we are commencing, like either it's a compression test, it's a tension test, puncture, anything. So we have to keep that in mind. Then we need to keep in mind that some probes are specifically designed for specific applications. Like Ms. Ragini was telling, the friction rig and the hair combing rig and some Delrin probes for gel strength and all. So those are specifically designed for a specific purpose. Then the load cell employed. Ms. Ragini told that we have a load cell from 0.5 kg to 750 kg. So we need to keep in mind what load cell we are using for probe selection. And last but not the least, I would say there is no harm in referring application guide. Because whatever we are speaking since morning, it's already there in the software. We are just revising it to you. Fine. So let's go further. The sample type. For selection of probe, I would say two things are important. First, think. Second, visualize your test. So I have placed a picture here. It's nothing. It's just a perk bar. You must have seen a Cadbury perk bar. Right, and I'll discuss why I have set this picture. So first of all, you have to ask yourself that will the probe be able to cover or measure the representative area? The motive of placing this picture is, I got this sample from Cadbury, right? And they wanted me to test the puncture strength. So now the question arises, which probe should I use? Whether I would use P by 2, P by 4, P by 6, P by 10 or a bigger probe, right? So any one of you recommend P by 2N? You know the P by 2N probe? It's a needle probe of 2mm diameter. Will you recommend to test it?
No.
If no, why?
It's very small, so it will not penetrate inside, it will not puncture it.
Okay.
And it's a porous material.
Fine. I will like agree with this point. It's a porous material. So the should I use P by 6 for it?
Yeah.
Should I use P by 6?
Maybe.
Any one of you support this fact? I did buy P by 6. Reason behind is, see, it's a porous material. You already told that. There are some voids inside. And if I go by P by 2N probe, if I puncture by P by 2N probe, so the void size may be bigger than the probe's area. Right? And that may leave that void. But if I am going to use a probe which has a bigger diameter than the void size, then obviously my test would be a success. Is it okay? You buy the fact? Fine. So, is it important that what the probe is able to cover the representative area? That is the most important thing. Second, which property it possesses. My objective was to test the hardness only. If I want to check crunchiness or crispiness of the product, I will not use a smaller probe. I will use a bigger probe, even I will cut it, or I will do multiple puncture in this, or a multiple cutting test. Because my objective of testing is to test the crunchiness, not this, the hardness of the bar. Right? And the same thing, which property you want to assess? You want to assess, sorry. You want to assess whether you are going to check for the hardness of surface, you want to check the structural hardness of the bar, whole bar, or you want to test the crunchiness. So it all depends on your requirement. I'll place the ball in your court always in my presentations. It's you who are going to decide, not the machine. Right? So sample time is most important. Then the type of test. This thing you have seen in my colleague's presentation, but I'll again emphasize on that. Like, I would like to ask you, you can read from here, what is the actual difference between penetration and this compression test? You have the answer actually, my colleague already told you.
In compression test, the probe diameter is larger
right.
than compared to sample.
Right.
But in penetration, the probe diameter is lesser than compared to
right.
sample. Right. So it is like
penetrating. This is true. Someone has mentioned cheese block in the morning. Who working on cheese block? You mentioned cheese blocks. And you asked what probe should I use for cheese block. So, the same thing. First, I'll comment on that. A compression test, like you said, area is important, and penetration again area. And one more thing, penetration test gives you the sample surface property. Like you can remember that bar in my previous slide, if I want to test the surface only, or in cheese also, if I am going to compress it with a point, with a pointed probe or with a smaller dimension probe, I am going to assess the surface first. Right? But if I am going to compress the whole thing, if it is a bar, if it's a cheese block or anything, if it's a tablet. So I am going to compress the whole body and I am checking the structural hardness, not the surface hardness. Both are different things. Right? So you need to keep that in mind. So it is written there. And then the type of test. This is important. There is an example written here, butter cutting. You may be knowing there are different probes used for cutting. It's a blade set that we have, you must have seen. Which is called SDP by BS. We have a craft knife, which is a sharp knife blade. You must have seen it. There is a wire knife, which is used for butter cutting. So it all depends on sample consistency. A butter can be cut through a wire, fine. But a biscuit cannot be cut through a wire. Fine, so you need to keep that in mind. Then, I will say, the most important criteria of testing is try to implement in your mind, visualize it how I am going to test it. Like if you are going to use it for biscuit hardness or snapping force, how you will do it in general practice. You will just take a biscuit and snap it like this. Right? So it means you are going to have something which imitates this action. Two points, right? And a pressing at single point or bending like it. So it means you have to select a probe which should do this thing. So it should have a 3-point bend test, right? Similarly, if you are going to judge a vegetable, right, or a tablet. So what you will do? You just want to study the hardness of that. You will just compress it diametrically. Then it gives you the actual hardness of that product. And the adhesive test, surface area is again important. Like you, the people who are working with pharma, they must be doing micro-adhesion test. It's an adhesion test that how your product is going to adhere with the sample tissue, right? So in that case, important is the surface area of the product and the material of construction. A question was arise in the previous session that what is Zellerin and what is stainless steel? There's some other probe made of perspex. So it's given in the literature also that perspex is a material which resembles to glass. It is more, less brittle than glass. A Zellerin is kind of Teflon-like material, right, which can be used for stickiness and it's a smooth probe, and for gel, it would not cut the surface, it will just smoothly glide through it. And stainless steel probe, you all know. The last slide of this, don't forget it's your product and you know it better. Like tortilla we were discussing, sir, tortilla. you have made strips, and obviously if I am going to your tortilla, what I will do, I will just break it from my head, and I am going to test how extensible is this. And the same thing we apply in the tensile grip and extensibility test, right? A single extension will not work, and the PPA won't work for you. So this is all about the probe selection. Any other query? Yeah, please. Madam, it is about the objective of test. The lady has mentioned example because 36R, which is a compression probe having radius edge. We could have used only PPA 36, but that way it will be a cutting test, a penetration test. But now, whenever we are using a radius edge, it means we have no sharp edges. We are going to compress the material. We don't care about the external dimension. We are having a specific area we are going to compress. Fine, so it is a compression test.
So we cannot go with the basic.
Yeah, it is altered actually, it is altered as per your application. Somebody has mentioned tackiness. It is nothing but adhesiveness. The definition has changed. Thing is same, negative force. Right? Any other question? You're most welcome. Is your product requirement? You're most welcome. If you want to share anything about your product, fine, we can move further. I hope you all must have got the graphs, the practice graph in your laptops. Fine. So, interpretation. If you are using the instrument, you know there are many modes to calculate the data. Right. I guess that you load a project, run the test, and you simply click on the macro. This is what you do in general. Right. But I would first tell you how to calculate results manually.
It's this.
And then we will come for automatic calculation, which is macro. Because first of all, we should know how graph is being plotted and what are the properties we like intend to derive from it.
So you have the graph with you?
Fine, so Vadivelan has told you how to run a test. I am continuing with an octane graph.
I'll come to that.